of noise. Jackson Dart delivering to Gary Bryant Jr. on that famous down and distance here at USC, 4th and 9. It has been very good luck for the Trojans more than a few times. Last year's Keaton Slovis to Drake London game-winning touchdown against Arizona State, also on 4th and 9. And, of course, nothing more famous than the 2005 version of that. We welcome Jackson Dart to the program for the first time. Jackson, you made a lot of new fans over the weekend. I'm thinking about your old fans, though. You obviously weren't expected to play. How many people didn't tune in? How many people figured it out about halfway through that you were out there and this was your game? I'm wondering what your phone was like after the game.
Yeah, I would say I was pretty surprised. I have a ton of support from back home, which I'm super thankful for. And it was funny because my mom and my grandma were able to come to the game, and my dad was on an elk hunt. And at that time, when I came in, he was packing up, getting ready to leave, and he just had the game just radioed on his phone. And all of a sudden, his phone started blowing up from, you know, just his friends just saying, like, oh, like, Jax is going in the game. And then, you know, he shut down his plans and turned it on the TV. But, you know, I would say I was definitely surprised. I think there was a lot of people that I wasn't expecting that were tuning in and watching, and it was just a super cool experience.
Jackson, you showed a ton of heart in that game, man. I was giving you love on the broadcast. I was talking about you, man, look at this kid's limping and still throwing around. I mean, I know myself, if I was out there and we're down by 14 and I just had a couple bad plays and I had an exit stage left here on my ankle, I might have found a way to get out of that one. But I was proud of you, man. You showed a ton of heart. Where does that heart come from at such a young age? You developed that. Where does that come from for you?
Yeah, I would just say that, you know, the grit has kind of just been instilled by me, by my parents. You know, just them raising me just to always, you know, work on my perseverance and overcome adversity. You know, I kind of like took some of those plays that happened in the game early on and kind of found a similarity to my freshman year in high school. I was kind of just thrown in the fire at that time. And, you know, I made some early mistakes early on, and I made the mistake of holding on to it a little too long. And so when I was out there on Saturday, I was trying to just move on and worry about, you know, just the moment that I was in and make the next play.
Jackson, your week started with your head coach being let go, the guy that recruited you, the guy that brought you in here. Your week finishes with you on top of the ladder, holding the sword, rallying the fan base. Just walk me through the emotions of the past week for you, and how'd you handle all that?
Yeah, I'd say it's quite a roller coaster. You know, I just think that, you know, with everything that happened, you know, it shows a lot of character from, you know, the teammates and, you know, the people that we have in this program. And, you know, obviously it was just a huge shock to a lot of us. And, you know, it was something that, you know, like I said, we weren't expecting. I wasn't expecting. But we, you know, I have a lot of confidence in Coach Dante and the coaching staff around us and the players that we have. So, you know, we just try to come to work each week and just put our best foot ahead of us. And like I said before, you know, focus on the moment that we're in. And like Coach Dante always says, just go 1-0 on each rep and each moment that we have.
You're listening to Jackson Dart, the USC freshman quarterback, on Trojans Live. And Jackson, you know, now that you've looked at the film, how would you evaluate your performance? What did you think about the way you played?
Yeah, I would say, you know, early on, I think I had, like, my emotions get the best of me a little bit. You know, I was just super jacked up to be in there. And, you know, the game was just a little fast for me at the start. And later on, I was able to just, you know, hone in and find my comfortability that you know, each play that I could go through my reads. And I had a couple successful plays, which helped me a lot. And then I think that fourth down conversion, you know, gave me a lot of confidence. And I think that it was a huge boost for our team.
You got to take me through the eye black, bud. I know you're rocking that one eye cover, and I'm thinking, man, this guy didn't even know he was going to get in the game, but he was going to be on the sideline
right there
with just some eye black on. I really like that, man. Where does the eye black come from, and is this thing that is going to continue? This is your
signature,
right?
It better continue.
Oh, yeah, it'll definitely continue. I started it in high school. Saw, like, a LSU DB have it one time, and I was like, man, like, that looks really cool. And then, you know, I'm a big Star Wars guy, you know, and then me and my friends kind of changed it to, like, you know, Anakin Skywalker, who's got the scar. And so now I, like, just go out there and I kind of just correlate it to Anakin Skywalker.
Nice, the dark side, man.
Jackson, you got that gunslinger mentality. Where's that come from? Who do you model your game after? Who are you watching on Saturdays and Sundays saying, man, that's the That's the guy I'm modeling my my throwing after.
Yeah, I would always say that, like, how my football career started, like, I was always, like, a football player before I was a quarterback. So, you know, there was a lot of times where I'd have to, like, just make football plays. And, you know, watching guys like Brett Favre, you know, Patrick Mahomes nowadays, watch a lot of Zach Wilson, who, you know, I'm really good friends with. And just guys like that who are able to extend plays and, you know, they make one mistake and, you know, the very next play they could, you know, score a touchdown by just, you know, being aggressive and, like you said, being a gunslinger. So, you know, Coach Graham, that's kind of the mindset that, you know, he gives me, and I love it, and that's why I love this offense. So, you know, just move on to the next play and just have that gunslinger mentality.
You're listening to Jackson Dart. And Jackson, you know, you come in here with another freshman quarterback in Miller Moss, and I thought one of the cool moments I saw on the sidelines was when you guys realized that you were going in. He seemed more excited than you were. He was fired up for you to get out there. You know, it's always a weird thing, right? I mean, you guys are obviously competing, but what's that relationship like? Because it sure seemed like you were supporting each other on Saturday.
Yeah, definitely. I think, you know, with me and Miller coming in the same class, obviously we have a lot of competition surrounding us, and we knew that coming into it. And I think it's just been super cool how we've been able to just grow a relationship on and off the field. You know, obviously on the football field, we're going to go at it and we're going to compete each day, which he's a great competitor, and he's somebody that really pushes me. And I think that's just, like, helped our relationship. You know, we've gained a lot of respect for each other over the time that we've had here. And, you know, just off the field, he's just, like, a super cool kid, and we get along really well.
Jackson, the head coach planted a wet one on you, man, and you looked like he was pumped up for you, man. Was it mean?
The iPad question first, now this one.
Coach to have you back like that, man? Well, he's in the war with you. He's planting wet ones on you, man. What's that mean?
Yeah, to be honest, I wasn't expecting it, honestly.
Understandably so.
I was about to take a little swoosh of water, and, you know, got a little something on my cheek. But, yeah, I you know, Coach Dante, you know, when the whole situation happened, he reached out to me and just, you know, let me know that, like, you know, he was going to have a lot of confidence in our team and that he would have all of our guys' back. And, you know, I think that, you know, the amount of effort that he's put in and to this program and that he's shown, you know, in team meetings and just working through things with us has helped me gain a lot of respect for him. And, you know, I think that with, you know, just me being here and just working hard and trying to do my job each day, I think he's, you know, gained respect for me too. And to have that respect from a coach, I think it means a lot. And, you know, it makes you feel really comfortable when you're out there.
Jackson, I was super impressed with how fast you were processing things on Saturday. Usually that's the last aspect to come for true freshman quarterbacks. You know, they're holding onto the ball a little bit too long, you know, taking sacks and whatnot. I didn't get that vibe from you at all. How pivotal was it for you to come in early and have the spring practice and have that extra bulk of reps, so when your number is called in the fall, you have more experience at the Division I level to fall back on?
Yeah, I think that was huge coming in early. I couldn't really imagine myself coming in late and not having those reps that I had in the spring and just having the, you know, the relationships with the receivers and just working on timing and understanding the playbook and going through my progressions, like you said. So I think, you know, coming in the spring, it was super beneficial. Got a ton of reps, which helped a lot. And with our offense, you know, reps is kind of like the thing that it's based out of. You know, we're a progression-based offense. So, you know, it doesn't really matter the coverage. You just got to go through your progression. You got to trust it. And, you know, more times than not, there's going to be somebody open. So you just got to trust yourself and go through it. And I think that just having trust in my guys to get open for me was a big thing.
Well, it was a heck of a performance, a record-setting performance, Pac-12 Offensive Player of the Week, Freshman of the Week. Jackson Dart did it all up in Pullman. We appreciate you making your Trojans Live debut. I'm sure many more to come for the freshman quarterback. More of this show to come next. You're listening to Trojans Live.